everyone, this is Reena here. Welcome back to my channel, Mrs. Homemaker. Sometimes when we see other people doing some small task, we come to a conclusion that it's very easy to do. If it had been us, we would have done it far better and with far more efficiency. But frankly speaking, when we ourselves do that particular task, we find it very difficult, or we are not able to maintain the consistency with which that particular person was doing. Same thing happened with me when I was learning how to cook. These are my early days of cooking. Whenever I used to see my mom boiling rice, simple rice, white rice or pony rice or basmati rice, she did it perfectly. Every time, each day, the rice cooked very well. And I used to think to myself, it's very easy to do. Just add water, salt and boil it. It's done. But frankly speaking, when I myself started doing it, it was so difficult for me to maintain the same consistency each day. Either I would burn it, or the rice would become very mushy, or I will half cook it. So, obviously, it was very frustrating and irritating for me. Therefore, through years, I learned many tricks around it and from different people. And I came to a conclusion. I through testing and kind of every time experimenting, I came to this conclusion, this particular method, which is so helpful. I don't even have to think twice. I follow the same pattern every day, and the rice that I boil is done quickly with efficiency, and it's not mushy. It's just cooked perfect. The grains don't wear off. I mean, it doesn't become mushy. They don't break, and the grains are long. They boil full, they cook full, and it's not mushy. So I thought I should share the method with you, since many of my friends were wanting to know, how do I boil rice? Is there some method with which they can boil rice with perfection? So the method that I'm going to share with you today is specifically around pony rice, basmati rice and the white rice. So this method goes seamless with all the three type of rice. If you boil them with this particular method, you are going to get perfect grains every time. I mean, you perfectly cooked rice every time. Do watch this method and let me share this method with you.
Take a clean, deep pan to wash the rice. Take any good quality white rice, basmati rice or pony rice. To show you here, I have taken basmati rice. Take a bowl, and we will be taking it one full bowl of rice as a measure. Let's start our method. Take a clean bowl. Fill this bowl up to the brim with rice, because we would be boiling one full bowl of rice. Here I have taken one full bowl of rice, and this is basmati rice. Which I use for everyday cooking. Sometimes I use basmati, sometimes I use pony rice, but the method is always the same. Put this bowl of rice into the pan that we've taken earlier. We now need to wash this rice properly. Ensure that you use clean water to wash. You just need to stir it a bit. Just give it a slight stir. No need to mash it. If you mash it, the grains will break. You can see the dirty, cloudy water. You just need to throw this. And wash the rice 3 to 4 times. It is a must, because this way all the powder or any kind of, additional things that are added to rice for protection from insect will be washed off. wash the rice properly till the time you get water clear. The water should appear very clear. So the time it appears to be clear, you know that it has been properly washed. You can now see that the water is clear enough, which means that our rice is properly being washed. Let's take this for cooking. Take a thick pan for boiling rice. This is one of my old and very favorite vessel for boiling rice. This is one of my favorite vessel. Reason being, it's very thick. The walls and the bottom is very thick of this vessel. And this helps the rice not to burn. As the heat spreads with consistency, the complete rice boils perfectly. Cover the rice completely with water. Now that you have covered the rice, ensure that you take one knuckle up water. Fill the water to one knuckle up from the level of the rice. Keep pouring water till you reach that particular level. Don't go beyond this level. Before cooking, ensure you keep the rice separate for 5-10 minutes and boil only after it. Keep that rice for rest for 5-10 minutes, and now I am about to boil it. I'll be putting salt as per taste. That's it. I've taken approximately half a spoon of salt. Cover it with a deep plate so that you can pour water on that particular plate or cover. I have put water in it, and now I would be giving one boil to the rice. Give it a single boil and simmer it for 15-20 minutes once it gets boiled. After 15 minutes, you will see that the complete water has been absorbed by the rice and it's almost cooked. I will show you how well it has been cooked. There is this little trick that I always adopt. Now cover this rice back again with that plate which has hot water and keep it for another 5-10 minutes. After 5-10 minutes, when you remove the plate, you will see that all the grains have been properly and separately cooked. See how well it is cooked. Each grain is separate and has almost doubled and tripled its normal size. It's not sticky at all. It's not overcooked. It's not half cooked. It's just perfectly cooked. There's nothing added to it. No oil, no ghee, nothing. Just plain water and little salt. See how good it is cooked. Your rice is ready.
Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to press the like and subscribe button.